The name's Bond, James Bond, and 007's classic Aston Martin DB5 is arguably the most famous car he drove. Problem is, it vanished without trace 24 years ago in a heist worthy of a Bond villain. Now the race is on to solve the real-life mystery.
Well, this is the most famous car in the world.
You'll be using this Aston Martin DB5.
This is the James Bond car from Goldfinger. There's nothing else like it.
Smokescreen, oil slick, left and right front wing machine gun.
I'm getting FBI agents, former MI6 agents, donating their time to help me. People want to see the stolen car returned.
Tonight, we're on the hunt for the most famous Bond car of them all, a Connery classic that simply disappeared into thin air almost a quarter of a century ago. It was an outrageous heist that has more twists and turns than a Bond blockbuster.
It's a great story. There's probably a movie to be made.
It's like a kind of whodunit, isn't it, really? The mystery continues.
It's a tale almost as famous as the spy who drove it. Just how and who would steal the most famous car in the world?
I believe that it will be recovered, and programs like yours are going to help us do that.
Just where on earth could that car be now?
Now, pay attention, please.
Goldfinger, 1964, and Q hands 007 the keys to a tricked-up Aston Martin DB5 that became as famous as the actor himself.
Whatever you do, don't touch it.
No, why not?
Passenger ejector seat.
With a gambit of gadgets, the DB5 became 007's car of choice in several later franchise releases. The original Aston Martin, with all its props, was snapped up at auction in 1986 by colourful US businessman Anthony Puglisi. He stored the one-of-a-kind classic in a Florida airport hangar. Then, 11 years later, thieves pulled off a daring plan in the dead of night.
The car was very unceremoniously dragged out by its axle, put on the cargo plane, never to be seen again.
The mystery has perplexed authorities and enthusiasts for nearly 25 years, including a famous British actor.
That if you want me to be a one-woman man, well, that's just groovy, baby.
Liz Hurley might have famously turned down a Bond girl role, but she's revving up even more interest in the car's whereabouts with her new podcast series.
The Great James Bond Car Robbery, with me, Elizabeth Hurley.
You never know who is eventually going to come forward and say, I know where this car is.
Well, some people say it must have been dropped over the ocean. Some say that it is in the Middle East. Some say it might be in Brunei. One never really knows.
At Britain's famous Silverstone racetrack, James Bond stunt driver Mark Higgins shows me how to handle a replica Aston Martin DB5. Mark shares his own stunning theory as to where the original car might be now.
I think it's buried somewhere. I can't believe in this day and age that somebody somewhere wouldn't know about it. And with social media and the way people talk about things, you'd like to think they would have leaked it out.
Aston Martin historian Steve Waddingham is on a different track.
Well, I'm a romantic, so I like to think it's there, out there somewhere, with somebody that must be almost like a Bond villain, I'd imagine, but who knows?
So just where could the real-life Bond villain be? The car's owner, Anthony Puglisi, received an insurance payout of more than $4 million. Puglisi has a checkered history involving fraud and theft in unrelated matters. But investigators have ruled him out of this plot. The car is now thought to be worth between $30 and $40 million.
I'm looking for a Silver Birch DB5 Aston Martin.
Investigator Chris Marinello from Art Recovery International has been on the case for a decade. He's now closer than ever to solving one of the world's most infamous car thefts after receiving his best tip-off yet.
somebody was pretty confident they had seen the car and knew something that no one else knows about the car. And I'm not going to tell you what that is. We're going to leave that for when the car is recovered.
Chris can't reveal too much because he doesn't want to compromise the investigation. However, the signposts point to someone with deep pockets in the Middle East.
It led me to believe that the car is somewhere in the Middle East in a massive collection amongst thousands of vehicles. Aston Martins, Ferraris, Lamborghinis, just waiting to be discovered.
Chris suspects the collector probably didn't realise the iconic car was stolen at the time he acquired it, but he certainly does know now. Chris hopes to shake and stir him into action.
And incidentally, we'd appreciate its return.
Unlike this request from Q, there's actually no need for the car to be returned. Just like the movies, a discreet deal can be done if the person reimburses the insurance company and pays Chris a fee for his efforts, then they can keep the car, no questions asked.
I really would like this individual, this collector, to approach me before I have to approach him.
Oh, there's got to be a thriller in that mystery for sure. A reward of $100,000 is an offer for anyone with information that leads to the famous car's recovery.